you were born after the mid-50s, you don't know what polio was.
What it was terrifying. Before the polio vaccine, the virus would leave a healthy person weak or paralyzed and in excruciating pain in a matter of hours.
Summertime was full of terror for parents. In 1952, for instance, 57,000, mainly children, came down with polio, and generally during the summer months, July, August, a little bit of June, September, and you still see people who suffer the effects of having had the disease. It was terrifying.
And so was the treatment. The iron lung was a metal tube which used air pressure to inflate and deflate the lungs of paralyzed patients, and it was a miserable existence.
Being confined in this long metal tube for days at a time, not really being able to have any human contact, not being able to move much, it seemed like the most awful thing that could conceivably happen.
But then the most wonderful thing anyone could conceive of happened. In 1952, Jonas Salk developed an effective vaccine, and by 1954, children were lined up everywhere to get it. This community vaccination was held inside the studio at KPLR in 1960.
Though the disease has been for the most part eradicated, one vestige still remains, the March of Dimes, started by President Franklin Roosevelt, who himself was a victim of polio.